Hey everybody and welcome. For this first assignment, we're asking you to introduce yourself using the Animate Characters quick action in Adobe Express. So let's go ahead and get started and let me show you how to do this. All right, everybody, let's get started. To get going here, you're going to go to new.express.adobe.com. Now to use Adobe Express, you're already going to want to set up your Adobe ID and login information. I highly recommend, at least for this class, that you use your UCF.edu information and credentials when you're purchasing and logging into your Adobe Creative Cloud. Once you get to the homepage, you're going to be greeted with a lot of different options, which can be really exciting and also really distracting. So for now in this lesson, I want everyone to navigate to the giant plus sign at the top of the screen. You can find it under the rainbow Adobe A. Left mouse click on that and you'll have this menu that appears on the screen. You'll have the words create and the word quick action. Select the word quick action by left clicking and look in your quick actions and find the quick action animate characters. Left click on animate characters to pull up the window, and here's where the magic happens. You have hundreds of characters to choose from. All different characters, like different creatures, different people, different costume characters. My absolute favorite has to be the Bionic Kids series, so shameless plug here. Myself and UCF professor Victor Davila actually worked on these characters with Adobe to get them in Adobe Express, and they represent the Limitless Solutions nonprofit here at UCF, which I am creative director for. So we're super stoked to have these representational characters in Adobe Express. Now, moving forward with that, once you find your character, you're going to go over to the background tab and you can either upload your own image or you can go through and cycle through different types of imagery within your Express options. And I can scale up and down my character to fit those. I can also then go to size, and using the dropdown, I could set my size. We are gonna be using YouTube for this size, and we're going to be creating a 16:9 style screen here. All right. Finally, it's time to record. So for this assignment, I'm asking you to introduce yourself and basically tell us a little bit about yourself and your experience in the digital art and what you're majoring in, UCF, all that fun stuff. So to do that, you're going to go ahead and hit the record button. If you're in a louder area or have background noise, I do recommend to check the enhanced speech button here. It's gonna make it just a little bit easier to kind of have that audio sound studio quality finish. Now, I'm using a decent microphone, so I'm not going to check that, but I'm gonna hit record and let's go for it. Hey everybody, my name is Matt Dombrowski and welcome to Intro to Computer Art. Over the next 16 weeks or so, we're gonna go on a creative journey learning all the different tools in Adobe Creative Cloud. Let's get ready and start creating. All right, when I'm done, I'm gonna hit that done element there. And it's going to upload, submit, and it's going to start to process the animation. Now behind the scenes, what's happening essentially is it's taking the inflection of my voice and it's mapping it to specific gestures and actions within the character. For your submission, you can use any character and any background that comes in Animate Characters. So it's completely up to you. Really explore your creativity and have some fun with it. It should roughly take a minute or so to process everything. There's rare times where maybe it may not process that quickly, but you can always hit cancel, re-record, and it usually goes through. Just make sure you're using a steady internet connection and everything's all set with that. Once we wrap up here, it's gonna go ahead and bring up a window in which we can download. And we have two options here. We can download this or open this in our editor. For this assignment, you can go ahead and directly download. You can even go ahead and trim little parts of your clip off. Hit download, and that's gonna save it to your file. All right, in the next step, I'm gonna show you how to upload this clip to YouTube and embed it in your discussion post. So while this exports, hang out, and we'll be right back. All right, welcome back, everyone. Now it's time to get things set up so we can upload our clip to YouTube. We're going to be using YouTube just for a few assignments. Creating a YouTube account is completely free. You just need basically a free Gmail account to do so. Once you create your YouTube account, what I'm going to do is navigate over to the Create button at the top right and go to Upload Video, which is going to pull in a specific prompt for me where I can drag and drop my file or even just hit Select Files. And for that, I will double click on that great introduction that we created. And I'm going to say Matt's introduction to the discussion. All right. And we're going to call this GRA2101C Bionic Kid Introduction. Awesome. Now, at this stage, you're pretty much good to go. I'm going to go ahead and just drop this into the Introduction to Computer Art playlist. You will not have that option. That's just for me to organize the files for you. You can see that the clip does load. It's going to take a second for it to get into full resolution. So give that, again, just a hot minute to do that. And then we're going to hit Next. And is it made for kids? In our case, we'll just hit No. That's a little easier just to do that. Any of the licensing, we don't need to worry about. All the copyright checks should be fine. And visibility, you can use public or unlisted. If you do public, what you're going to want to make sure is it's just going to show up to the world, but do not check private here. I'm going to then hit publish. There you have it. And now we have a bit of a file link that we can use, or we can simply hit close and it will show up in our videos. So if I select this video, and I click that link. Hey everybody, my name is Matt Dombrowski and welcome to, there's our clip. So the next step you need to do to get it submitted is hit the share button, go to the embed code, and we're gonna just copy this embed code using Command C or Control C, or even just hitting the copy button here. And I'm gonna take that clip and navigate over to my discussion, hang out for a second, we'll be right back. All right, now that I'm in my discussions post, what you're going to want to do is I'm going to click view as student here just so you can see. This is kind of the view that you get. I'm going to hit the reply button and I'm going to go down to my post. Now in this post, I want to make sure you're embedding the URL. So what does that mean? I don't want you to just copy and paste the information. What I want you to do is I want you to think about how this would show up in the clip. So there is a little embed button under insert embed. And when you do that, you're going to just paste control V or command V, depending on the type of computer you're using. You're going to paste that embed code copied from YouTube, hit okay. And there you have it. Once you have this, you're ready to submit. You can just go ahead and hit the reply button and it's going to put it in. In my case, I'm a test student and you're good to go. The assignment will be complete. So at that stage, you are set and you can move on to the next content. I hope you enjoyed this lesson and there's so many possibilities for Animate Characters and I can't wait to see the creativity you use in introducing yourself.